How often do we hear from everyday people? His stories from someone who look like you, work like you, live like you do. The good, the bad, most importantly, the truth. Because we're not all celebrities. We don't have a camera following us around to document our reality, but we do all have problems, issues, an elephant in the room that we continue to avoid in hopes one day will fade away. Well, I say, let's talk about it. Part 2 of His Marriage a Necessity with special guests Nikki Tolliver, Sean Massey.
It just comes with different parts of your life. And like I said, the older that I get, I recognize that I want to have someone to grow old with. Whereas before, in my 20s, 30s, it was marriage. What? I don't want to be married. For what? It doesn't make sense. There's too many compromises. I can live by myself. I can do what I want to do. I can buy my own house. I can have my own car. But the older I get, I do recognize, like, I don't want to just be right. I want to explore being with someone.
My decisions, it goes back and forth. Like, I'm like all for it. It's a great idea. And then something will just be like, you know what? No.
Never mind. Yeah, yes. No, you're absolutely, I just said with periods. So those periods, they come.
I've been engaged twice in my life and they're like, Jackie, just scared of the aisle. It's between me saying yes and actually doing the planning. It's like, I am giving up my freedom. I'm becoming a slave. I don't know. Like, it's just, it's like a whole lot of things flash before me and having to deal with situations and things that are uncomfortable. Like you said, the vulnerability, thinking that you have to fight through that with someone. That's a little scary to me in my age right now.
Mm-hmm. You've also, like, on the financial side, you worked hard to build what you have.
Yeah.
And then you recognize, like, okay, if I go into this with someone, how much am I willing to share with someone else? Am I willing to share all of it, some of it, or none of it? And we build something together.
Right.
Whereas the things that we already have, we just keep those separate. Like, that's yours and that's mine, and let's build something together. So you do have to think of those things.
My friend was saying, let's sell this house. And I'm like, oh, whoa, wait a minute. So that's already rub me the wrong way, buddy. I'm not selling my house. I have a kid. So I'm trying to change the trajectory of Black children get married. They have to put out their loan. I want to be able to leave my child or give him a fresh start when he's 25, 26. He has a house that's mortgage free. That's my plan with this house. So I plan to buy another house, but not at the expense of selling my house. So it's a lot of things that make me uncomfortable when it comes to, asking myself, is marriage a necessity? I wake up on Tuesday and it's yeah, and on Friday it's like, not really.
And then you have to weigh the pros and cons, like, do we really have to get married?
How often do you weigh those pros and cons, though? How soon do you make your pros and cons? Like, Nikki, you said you and your husband established early, if I cook, you do the dishes. You came up with that understanding early.
I think everything is trial and error, too. And it's bad to say, because, you know, marriage is supposed to be this permanent thing forever. But some people don't get it right on the first time. Some people get it right on the second time. Some people, it may take four times before they get it right. Or do they ever get it right?
What is right, though? When you say
right is what you are okay with.
Nikki said, it's what marriage looks like to you. It's finding that puzzle piece. When we do pros and cons, maybe we need to do it with ourselves. Like, what am I willing to give up? If I had to give something up, what would it be? What can I not budge on? I'm not budging on this.
And I think those lists change as you grow and get older. And I think marriage doesn't necessarily have to be the necessity, but it could be partnership is what's necessary, especially with all of the concerns about property, about those things. Those are legitimate concerns. So I would say, having those conversations, and I brought this to the table, I want to keep this. Right. This is mine. I'm not going to budge on this, is an important aspect of a relationship.
Having it sooner than later. And it's all about the language. Like you said, Nikki, you went to premarital counseling. They provided you with the language. My niece was talking about, there's a book about the love languages. And I think that learning your partner is very important. Figure out as sooner than later what you have in common with that person, having the conversations of some of your aspirations in life, and see how much they line up, even making a mental note.
There are always signs. I've learned that. There are always signs. Whether we want to see them or not, some things we've seen and we just didn't want to admit that we saw. Listening, paying attention to the nonverbal communication. I listen. I have not dated in the last decade. I just want to put that. But I used to listen to the communication between their friends and them. How that went. You can't tell me you're a respectable dude and everybody you hang around is trash.
Right.
Like, you trash too. You trying to hide, but you out here trying to save them or something? Like, get out of here. You trash too, you know?
Exactly.
So, like, I always paid attention to those things. And if we made it long enough to be introduced to family, I mean, that wasn't the only thing, but I would pay attention to the interactions between your family. Like,
I value the fact that, Nikki, you have a three-dimensional view of marriage and how you view it, of partnership, by you being so involved in the church. Because I know a lot of women in the church that are like, everything revolves around the Bible, as life should be. I mean, you have...
Listen, the wonderful Bible, I study it. It's a wonderful Bible, but it was written thousands of years before my existence. There's nothing to tell me about what happens when somebody slides in your DMs. You know what I'm saying? What should I do in my marriage about that?
How do you handle that?
You know what I'm saying? I look at the Bible as a tool of inspiration, mm-hmm, and information, and not a measuring rod.
You have your Christian beliefs, but you have some people that's Christians on Sunday, and then you
arrest the cops who killed Breonna Taylor. No.
then you have...
Listen, when people say biblical marriage, it just gets under my skin, because show me a healthy marriage in the Bible.
Okay.
Show me a woman who wasn't viewed as property in the Bible. So when people say that, it's like, obviously you're not reading that Bible you trying to quote to me. Because in those times, women, we were property. We were viewed as property. And a lot of situations in the Bible, which we won't get into. But I would just say it is not the example of a marriage that I would want to be in.
Right.
Let me say that.
We are in a different time, and people see things in a different way, and you gravitate to what you feel like relates to you, mm-hmm, or what you want to believe in. Let me quote this, because this is how I want to be perceived.
It's an interpretation. Mm-hmm. So I'm able, the Bible, we don't have the original Bible. No one has it. So anybody says that, they're crazy. Right. But all of it is an interpretation. And anybody who gets up, preaches, teaches Bible study, whatever you want to, they're giving an interpretation of what they believe it to say.
So I had a professor at TSU. We had to do a report where she assigned us county, and she was like, read this information. She said, I'm going to tell you, you're going to do it just like they did in the Bible. She said, people picked the stories that they wanted to put in it. They told it the way that they wanted to tell it. Mm-hmm. She said, so you're going to tell me about this county the way that you want me to see it through your eyes. And she said, do you think that they put every story in the Bible? Like, yeah, we're going to put this going. You put the stuff that you felt you wanted people to hear, you know, read.
And that went with the story you wanted to tell.
Yeah, whatever story. It's like, no, we ain't gonna, it was probably a Jackie in the Bible and they didn't tell my story.
Just snatched
I'm sure
that right
there
on
was.
We don't take it.
And like when you were talking, Jackie, about your teacher, and I'm like, yo, you need to send her an offering, because what she's talking about is a canon. That's what it's called. The Bible is actually a canon. So they put in stories. There are Gospels that didn't make it.
It's good to get that type of rainbow of the colors and so forth, and see what people who actually been in relationships who are married get their intake on it, and not always be pressed to go back against
the norm. I think that society has this way of making you feel like you have to go with the norm, or with the masses as to how they feel and how they react to things. And anyone who has their own personality should say, no, that's not what I want. I want to do it this way. And if you don't like it, so what? I have friends that are married. Their spouses feel like they shouldn't hang around anyone but those people that are married. And they're like, no, like, you know, this, how does that work? That's not society. That's not how life really is.
Like you were saying, we don't have a Bible that teach you what happens when somebody slides in your DMs. When you have these conversations, you're teaching people by experience. When you tell your truth, it's important that you tell people your truth so they can learn from that. Those stories that are in the Bible are just that, they're stories. So when you share your truth, your story with someone, then they can be like, okay, so this is what happened when this person did it. This looks familiar to me. I might not be able to go to John's or go to Corinthians, but I can compare this today living experience with my own. Right. And I can say, okay, so this is how I can handle this. I have an option of how to handle this. We are living in our own generational biblical form, where we are creating, you know,
the story.
Yeah. Right. we're doing that. We're the lessons that we learn, but we have to share those lessons and not cover them up and be like, oh no, I'm gonna erase that. That don't even look
right. It doesn't look professional. Right.
White out and you changing your story to, you know, I was distraught. No, I was hurt. I was gonna kill this mug. Like, it's just right. This is what happened. And then, you know, I would say, and I grew from that instead of, you know, when I gathered myself, that's not the truth. Like, give me the truth. I want right. the truth so I can know my options. And then maybe something that you say will inspire me and motivate
Absolutely.
Me to where I can make decisions, because I can't. Where is a Mary?
It's called what I call preaching the text of our times. Mm-hmm. It does me no good to talk about Mary and I don't talk about the fact that Jackie raised a son who was a single parent and there are struggles in that.
I do like that it's a rainbow of ways to look at things, and for Nikki not to look at it in a biblical aspect just because she is in the ministry, that's great that you have those different views on things.
I don't know if it's because she's from the north, though. They don't know how they...
It could be.
We get it right up there.
No. y'all did.
And then you bring us out.
Hey, y'all freed the slaves. So you get out of my vote. Y'all did that.
But I married a Southern man. So look.
But you married a Southern man. So
I did.
You got the best of both worlds.
And you know, I will say that. I will say.
Mm-hmm. That's what's needed. The fact that you have this union with someone who loves you for you, you love them for them. That's important for people to know that I don't have to be in the church. I don't have to do this checklist of to become a wife.
And it's the submissive wife, the one that follows the Bible.
People take it and then they apply it to like their relationships and their marriages. Like, a woman should be submissive. Okay. I mean, if you want to do that, I'm cool with that. But it also says that, you know, a man should love his wife like Christ loved the church. I ain't never seen him get crucified for me.
No. So, hey.
I think the best thing I can ever say about marriage is it's absolutely what you make it. I believe in marriage. I think marriage is fantastic for who it's for. It's not for everybody. And I believe marriage is never the miracle. We'll just get married and things will be better. It doesn't happen that way. And there are some people who are married that certainly should not be married and they're in an unhealthy situation. I don't put marriage over partnership, partnership over marriage. And a healthy partnership over marriage is what we all should be hoping and looking for and still working for, even though those of us who are married, to make sure our partnership stays healthy, because marriage is not the abracadabra of the situation.
With that said, would you say marriage is a necessity?
No, I do not feel that marriage is a necessity. I feel like we can be our own individual person, still have friendships, relationships, without being married. Now, it's all about, do you want that or not? And that's just how I feel about it.
I'd say no, but I guess it depends on who you're asking, but I don't think it's a necessity. A necessity for what? It can't stop love. It can't start love. I guess it's a necessity if you're trying to figure out who to leave your property to. But is it a necessity to be in relationship with someone? Absolutely not. We know this from, there are countless of queer marriages or relationships that took place that weren't legal for many, many years. And even our ancestors, slaves, their marriage just weren't legal. So is marriage a necessity for love? No. But if that is what you want to do, go for it.
Go for it. I'm with you. Go for it.
And, you know, because we sit here and we like, nah, marriage ain't a necessity. But if we dating a man and he like, nah, I'd be like, what you mean? So you don't love me?
So you don't want to marry
me? Love me enough to marry me? Like, what? Like, it's a whole different conversation. Like, your response better be, I didn't think marriage was a necessity. Until I met you, like, Nick, get smart.
Yeah, that's right. Great answer. What? You don't want to marry me?
Yeah, your dude said he don't want
to marry me. That's when that comes. So what are you trying to say?
Yeah, so what am I to you then? So what are we doing? Like, so when
we friends.
Yeah. Hey, that's the whole conversation changed. I don't feel like marriage is a necessity. I would love to be in a position, I would love to do the self-work, like you said, Nikki, to where I am ready. I'm currently trying to do that and prepare to where I am ready to be in a marriage. But do I feel like it's necessary? No, I don't feel like it's necessary. I don't feel like it will make me a respectable woman. I feel like how I act and how I treat others and how I represent myself will make me a respectable woman, not necessarily carrying another man's name. But I think that if you can get in that space, do you want to be right or do you want to be in a relationship? Sean, like you said, I don't want to be by myself. I probably want a partnership. But does that mean that you have to sign that license to say that, hey, now we're binded. You have to be willing to do the work and you have to do your own work. As Nikki said, personally, I would love to be married. Well, ladies, I would like to thank you all for joining me on this segment. I would like to thank the viewers and the listeners for tuning in. Remember that healing happens one conversation at a time. I am Jackie Wade. Let's talk about it. Let me see your shirt, Nick.
Oh, yeah. Oh, ooh, I've been sitting so. The kill Breonna John. Taylor.
I like
and then
that.
It's got a picture on the back, man. I've been sitting so long.
Say her name. Oh, that's cute. Love I like that. It.
Yeah.
Actually bring attention to my Africa earrings.
Which are fabulous.
From yes. Ebony Lady. You guys check her out. They're amazing. So I put these on today.